There's tons of co-op games to pick from. You and your friends versus zombies, aliens, and pretty much anything else you can think of. But with so many of them, it can be hard to choose which ones to play, especially when you factor in price, number of players, and if it's even fun or not. This is a series where I will cover all of those things and more, so that you and your friends can find your next co-op game. Today's game is Left 4 Dead 2.
Kill all sons of bitches. That's my official instructions.
Left 4 Dead 2 is essentially the king of co-op games. If you've ever seen any lists of good cooperative games, then this one is pretty much always on there.
There it is.
And there, and there, and there, and there. But that's also why I figured it'd be a good game to start with. And that's Left 4 Dead 2 specifically, not Left 4 Dead 1. I'll get more on that later in the video. Left 4 Dead 2 is a first-person shooter game where you play as a group of people trying to survive the zombie apocalypse. The gameplay consists of you and your friends using lots of fun weapons to fight through tons of zombies in a variety of different campaign settings. Each campaign consists of a series of chapters, which are broken up by safe rooms that allow players to stock up on ammo and health supplies before venturing out again. At the end of the level, players must hold out against hundreds of the undead, as well as the boss zombie, the tank, until a rescue vehicle arrives to save them. Regular zombies are not the only thing to worry about in this game though, as there are many different special infected zombies that have abilities to stop you and your team. Overall, this game is zombie killing fun at its absolute best, and in my opinion, the perfect starting point for cooperative gaming overall. Left 4 Dead 2's co-op gameplay is a staple in the genre for a reason. It's a game that forces you to work together. The special infected zombies all possess abilities that are made to tear your team apart. If you're caught by the hunter, you get pinned down until a teammate pushes it off you or kills it. If nobody does, you will die. The same goes for the smoker that drags you and pulls you away from the group, the charger which grabs and pummels you into the ground over and over, and the jockey which...
Holy shit, that thing's riding him!
Well, you get the point. And of course, this is only a snippet of the special infected zombies that you fight in the game. But this idea of forced cooperation also goes for many of the other aspects in Left 4 Dead 2. Of course, you'll gradually lose health as you play, but you can find health packs that you can use on yourself, but you can also give to your teammates who might need them more than you. You can help others up when they're hanging off a ledge, or even revive them if they've been killed using a defibrillator.
Ow, what the hell are you shocking me for?
And hopefully that's enough to help sell you on why you should just play this game. I've been playing Left 4 Dead 2 since it first released back in 2009. First on the Xbox 360 and then later on Steam, which I've honestly found is a much better experience overall of the two. The game is infinitely replayable and features a system where the zombies and weapons spawn differently every time you play, so no two playthroughs will ever be the same. And as I mentioned earlier, why not the original Left 4 Dead instead? Well, one of the great parts about Left 4 Dead 2 is that it contains every map released for Left 4 Dead 1. Essentially, all of the content, the characters, and the maps that were in the first game are in this game for free, if you play on the Steam version. The only difference is that you can use all of the weapons added in Left 4 Dead 2, as well as the melee weapons which were not available in the original. So essentially, you'll never need to buy the first game unless you just want that old experience of it, but honestly I would say don't bother. Like I mentioned though, this is only exclusive to the Steam version. If you have the Xbox version still, you'll have to pay around $7 each for all the Left 4 Dead 1 maps. So what else do you need to know to play Left 4 Dead 2? Well, first of all, how many players is it? Hopefully you already figured this one out based on the big four in the title, but as the name implies, you can have up to four players in the game at once. How difficult is it? The game has multiple difficulties to choose from, starting at easy and going all the way to expert. I still usually play on normal, since I find it's the most enjoyable with friends who just want to relax and have fun together without taking it too seriously. If you're new to first-person shooters, then this might also be a great starting game for you, since you'll always have the other characters in the game to back you up, regardless of how many real people are playing. Does it have split screen? On the Xbox version of the game, yes, it does have split screen, which you can even go online with a friend if you want to. But the Steam version is not as straightforward. The game doesn't have split screen by default, but you can make it work through workarounds that you can find out for yourself in plenty of video tutorials online. What other modes are there? The main mode is campaign. This is where you will do what I described before. Pick a campaign get from point A to point B, trying your best not to die. The other side modes are as follows. Realism, which is essentially the same as campaign, but the highlights around the characters and the items are turned off, making it a lot more realistic and, in my opinion, better. Survival, a mode where you hold out for as long as you can in a specific area. Mutation, a mode that changes how the game works, like starting the game using katanas with no other weapons spawning whatsoever. Versus, it's a mode where you can play as the special infected zombies trying to stop the survivors from reaching the safe room in a 4-against-4 fight. So here it is actually possible to have 8 people in the game, but you'll clearly be divided into 2 teams. Scavenge mode works like Versus, but has you collecting gas cans instead of running through campaign levels. So personally, I don't really touch a lot of these other modes anymore, and there's a good reason for that. It's because everyone's kinda fucking terrible online when it comes to player versus player modes, but if you can somehow find 8 actual friends to play with, then these modes can be a lot of fun. The Steam version also has a workshop where you can download fan-made content for free and super easily. You just look for stuff and then click subscribe and then you open the game and it's right there. And this means that there are infinite other campaigns to play that people have made, some of which I would say are actually better than the ones in the game. There's also a lot of other dumb ways to change the game, like having Master Chief replace all the characters, and each one being a different version of him from Halo 1 through 4. Or instead of having the regular level finishing music, you can have the Cory in the House theme play instead. And if this isn't perfection, then I just don't know what is. So, what is it available on? Left 4 Dead 2 was made by Valve, the company that actually owns Steam, so of course it's available on there for PC, and Mac and Linux as well. I own a PC and my girlfriend has a Mac and we never have any trouble connecting the two together. As I said earlier, it's also available on Xbox. If it's not obvious, there's no crossplay between the Steam version and the Xbox version. Is there controller support? Yes, there is controller support for the Steam versions of the game. The price. How much is this game? Left 4 Dead 2 sits at $11.49 on Steam in Canadian dollars. I am Canadian. And while that might sound good and tempting, you can actually get this game for as little as $2 on almost every Steam sale. On the Xbox side, you can probably find the disc version for around $5 at your local game store, as the digital version seems to somehow still be sitting at $20. I feel like it's not going to go down because they don't even probably look at it, so. And that's kind of it. This game is over a decade old now and it still holds up incredibly. My girlfriend and I have actually been playing it at least once a week for the last little while, and it's still really fun. They actually released an update recently called The Last Stand, which is it was a survival map from the original Left 4 Dead 1 that the community took and made into a full campaign, and it was backed by Valve. It's not super long, but it's free and it's definitely worth checking out. And of course, that survival map was also added in, which was the only missing content from the original Left 4 Dead. So there you go, the one more reason to get this game. Let me know if you end up trying Left 4 Dead 2 at all, if you somehow haven't yet, or even if you just jump back into it after watching this video, as well as if you have any other recommendations for good co-op games that I should cover in the future. If you have any co-op questions about the game, let me know in the comments below and I will do my best to answer them for you. Anyways, thank you for watching. I hope to see you in the next one.